with that,
we're going to go on to our new stuff.
And
so
this is some pretty substantive.
I'm going to have you explain this because it's something that I understand a little bit, but I'm still trying to figure it out because this will relate to the Kings of Leon album release that we'll talk about in a little bit.
So, yeah, let me start. The new thing that is happening in the music industry right now mm-hmm. is around NFTs. NFT mm-hmm. stands for non-fungible token. And immediately...
It's a really weird name to say it, but yeah.
Yeah, it's... I mean, it makes sense in an economics brain. Prepare for this for this clip. It's going to be a lot, but I think we work with it. So fungibility in economics is like a property of money. Yes. It basically means that you can replace it with another identical item. It's interchangeable. So for example, the US dollar, one US dollar bill is fairly interchangeable. It's easy to like trade $1 bill for another, or $4 for $1 bill, for example. Non-fungible means that this is a good that's one of a kind. You can't do anything with it. You can't duplicate it. It's like one type of it. And so because of that, it has value. Things like, you know, like antiques that were handmade or collections from the history that you can't find anymore. So now we have this idea of that basic economics 101 concept. Now we now go into cryptocurrency.
This is where it's fun.
Yeah. So what has started now is non-fungible tokens, which are a type of cryptocurrency, mm-hmm. which, and this is where the music part comes in. Non-fungible tokens can be any rare or relatively limited piece of art, for example.
Yes.
So it can be an art piece, or it can be video, or it can be music. You get where I'm following here? So what's happened over the past like week or so, there's the EDM artist Blau, spelled with a three. There's mm-hmm. a number of other artists. There's Grimes, who's kind of natural. Mm-hmm. Kings of Leon, who mm-hmm. we'll be reviewing in just a moment, yeah. are now starting to release things. Noted little bitch Daystar Peterson, are now all starting to release things as NFTs. And so you can do these on different platforms and different websites. And a lot of artists are going really far into it. For example, Kings of Leon has special limited editions that you can only get as like these NFTs, essentially, paying for them using cryptocurrency. It's a pretty interesting, like you can go into the minutia of it, but this stands to say that, okay, we're in a new decade. We've just spent the last decade where the tech companies dictated how much or essentially how little artists mm-hmm. get paid on the large. So this new decade is going to be a bunch of new reinventions of the idea of how do artists make money. And this is one of the direct ways, using honestly all of the buzzwords, which we won't get into my opinions on cryptocurrency and blockchain and all those other things. That's five separate videos, and I've already produced too much this week. But that's kind of the premise, where artists are going to be able to take back a little bit of the money that they should be getting by offering limited edition versions of their work in mm-hmm. like, you know, relatively limited ways online through the internet, and then buying them through cryptocurrencies. What has all those advantages of being a digital ledger, it's backed up, so you can, it's hard to fake the transactions. There's definitely a lot of benefits there, naming of which artists get paid more directly. So given that explanation, what do you kind of think about this?
So it's interesting because it's very, very niche. Not many people know what it is, and not many people know how it operates or anything like that. So it's a good explanation to get it out to the people, because we are for the people, by the people.
We try.
And like the whole thing with when I heard it from Kings of Leon doing it as an album through an NFT, I go, that's interesting, because how are they going to do that with an album? Like, is it going to be exclusive artwork, or is it going to be limited prints or something like that? That's basically what it is, where it's like a deluxe version or whatnot. That's only NFT. The rest will be streamed as just a normal album. So it's stuff like that, which I kind of like in a way for fans, because it gets fans a little bit more, well, I wouldn't say access, but more ways to feel like they're special. Feel like, oh, I'm really owning a piece of the art.
Yeah.
Then the other way too is some people may find this really annoying to get around, of how the fuck do I buy this, or what do I do?
There's a barrier.
I don't even
to entry.
Have crypto. If you're not in crypto at all, then there's a whole barrier of that part. So there's pros and cons with it. It'd be interesting to see more and more people doing it, because it sounds more popular, but it's a step in the right direction of artists getting control of their own artwork, which is my whole big thing on it. So
yeah, and there's so many, like, just
there's so many different avenues and stuff you can do with it as well, because there's a lot of complex things, because everything is getting changed daily, basically. So
yeah, there's a lot of advantages to disadvantages. Of course, once you go into blockchain and cryptocurrency, you have to talk about the fact that these processes are actually very energy inefficient. Mm-hmm. They require a lot of very powerful computers to be running.
Powerful computers.
To be running to all the time. Shit. To be running these calculations that effectively make these cryptocurrencies exist. Mm-hmm. And it uses a lot of power. Yeah. Power, and while there's a lot of solar and wind power that produces electricity, much of it's still coal, natural gas, oil burning. Mm. So there's those aspects to that. It's not like, again, this is a very weird, big thing. But I think the crux of it, which is what Sean got to there, is that this is going to be another way for fans to feel connected to artists in a bit of a unique way. Yes, there's that barrier to entry, but artists should be doing, it's an artist's best interest to make money in whatever ways are available to you, because the music industry is not going to bring the money to you. That's a decades old story. It's very good. Like we said, Grimes is going to be doing this. She's releasing some new money. She's releasing some new work, and she's already hit $6 million.
Jesus Christ.
The collection was made available on the NFT marketplace Nifty Giveaway. So yeah, there's all these different marketplaces for these things too. And Kings of Leon, who we're going to talk to in seconds, I tell you, they also released an album, a special edition of their album, When You See Yourself, as non-fungible tokens. This makes them the first band to make one of their full-on, proper LPs as a cryptocurrency. That makes it interesting. I don't know, as we said, and as we'll talk about in the review, it's available everywhere, so it's not like an exclusivity thing, but it will be interesting to see how this sort of develops.
It's just like the deluxe version, basically, so you get a little bit more stuff with it, but the whole album you can still stream on Spotify, Apple Music, the nine.
Some extra songs, maybe some little
artwork pieces
of the band.
Which, again, I like in regards, because then it gives it a little bit more access to people in that way, but then it's... Yeah. People need to learn how to do that stuff, which is still going to take a long time to do.
For sure.
Like, what the fuck is a crypto?